Daniel Kantor with MS World, coming to you from ECTRIMS in Boston. At this meeting, we also have other symposia, and one of them is called the European Charcot Foundation Symposium. Charcot was the grandfather of much of neurology, and actually the person who first gave multiple sclerosis a name, albeit it was in French. What we saw at the European Charcot Foundation Symposium is a presentation about antigens. What is an antigen? Many of you may have heard of antibodies. Antibodies are things that stick to other things. And we can think about antibodies in general in medicine, and more specifically in multiple sclerosis, you may have heard of monoclonal antibodies. Anytime a medicine has the word mAb, the letters mAb at the end of the word, that means that it's mono, it's one, it's clonal, they're all the same, and its antibody is one thing that sticks to another. The thing that the antibody sticks to is called an antigen. What we think happens in multiple sclerosis is that the body gets confused. And instead of just attacking foreign invaders, the body directs its attack against itself. And it directs it against its own antigens, as we call them. It would make sense in multiple sclerosis that our treatments would have to do with antigens. It would have to do with making your body tolerate them better. Unfortunately, thus far, medicines that work that way have not really worked for multiple sclerosis. We heard interesting discussions today from Professor Luderodi, Professor Hartung, and from Professor Selmai about different ways that we can think about treating multiple sclerosis using this idea of antigens. One of the ways that Professor Luderodi talked about was that instead of assuming that MS is always attacking the same part of the immune system, the same part of the nervous system is being attacked by the same part of the immune system, we may have to think that at the beginning it's one part, then it's another part, and then it's a third part, even in the same patient. And his research looks at trying to treat people in terms of multiple types of these antigens. Professor Selmai, who we were so lucky to have the opportunity to speak to personally, is actually the person who developed the myelin patch that many of you may have heard about and talked about for the past year. And it was great to hear his perspective on the study that lasted for a year, looked at MRIs, looked at safety, and looked at clinical responses. And so far, it's looking very, very hopeful. Thank you so much for joining us, and please stay tuned.